Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back. Today I want to talk about underrated makeup products that deserve more hype. I feel like on YouTube there are a lot of products that get talked about over and over again and we hear recommended a lot. And then there are some other products that I think are fantastic that I'm really not hearing anyone talk about. So I want to share those with you guys today. And I'm really excited to say that today's video is sponsored by Skylar. Skylar is a fragrance company and I was so excited when they reached out and wanted to work with me because I get comments constantly requesting me to talk about cruelty-free fragrance brands, and honestly, they're kind of tricky to find. I had a comment seriously like 3 days ago requesting this, and I'm sitting back like, ooh, little do you know, I have a video coming. And Skylar is actually Leaping Bunny certified cruelty-free, which is fantastic. They are available, of course, on their own website, but you can also purchase them at Sephora, so they're very accessible. Their line is hypoallergenic, cruelty-free, phthalate-free, and made here in the US. And I'm really excited to share the newest scent. This is called Sun Shower. Now let me read you guys the notes. We have lemon leaves, jasmine tea, and meadow greens. This just smells so like fresh and summery and light. They describe it as a renewing scent that symbolizes hope and joy. I just think this scent is so good. And I've actually been a little bit extra recently and layering these two scents from Skylar together. Today I'm wearing a little cocktail of both. This one is salt air and the notes are driftwood, sea salt, and seawood. And I feel like the perfect combo is like two spritz of this, one spritz of this. I feel like this scent would work really well for anyone. It's not too feminine, but it's also not too masculine. Even my boyfriend said that he would wear either of these two scents. I just love how simple and clean the fragrance is. Some scents can be so strong and overpowering that I'm kind of turned off from wearing them, but this one just feels so clean and fresh. And if you love that scent, they're also available as hand sanitizers right now, which is perfect because I know we're all like speeding through hand sanitizer these days. And I just think they're such a beautiful company overall. A portion of their proceeds goes to a nonprofit organization called Step Up, which helps underserved high school girls. Also, the founder and CEO is a female, which I think is amazing because we talked in a recent video about how few of the major beauty brands sold at Ulta and Sephora are run by women. Overall, I just think they're a really cool company and they definitely fit into the underrated category for today's video. And they did give me a coupon code. It's 15 Kelly G. You can get 15% off of these two fragrances right here, Sun Shower and Salt Air. And can we just talk about this packaging really quickly? You guys know I'm a sucker for really nice, beautiful packaging, and I just love how like simple and minimalist this is. Even the boxes that they came in, I don't even want to dispose of these because I just think they're so pretty. I'm a sucker for little details like that. So thank you so much to Skylar for working with me on today's video. I'll have some more information in the description box down below if you guys want to check it out. All right, so some more underrated products. Let's start off with this one. I don't even think I talk about this enough. This is from a brand called Undone, and they call this the Un Foundation, and I think that's a really great description of it because it's the complete opposite of your typical foundation. This is a sheer coverage skin tint, so I'm talking like the absolute least amount of coverage possible. So definitely don't go into this expecting something like the Pure, what is there? Love Your Selfie, is that the name of their foundation? The one I didn't love because it was like super full coverage. This is, don't think of anything like that. Even some more like lightweight and light coverage foundations, this coverage is significantly less. So I'll briefly compare it to this. This is the Pretty Fresh from ColourPop because I know so many people have tried this and love it. Texture-wise, super similar, very thin, almost kind of watery, but I would still say this has a decent amount more coverage than this. So I just want to be really clear from the start, this is the definition of sheer, but that's also kind of why I like it. And I had not used this in a while, and I put it in my most recent Shop My Stash rotation, and I'm really falling back in love with it because this is a really versatile product. I think there are two major ways that this product works. The first one is as a mixer. So if you have some full coverage or thick, heavy foundations, and you just want to lighten them up a little bit that day, mix in a little bit of this, it'll sheer it out, it'll lighten up the coverage, and it'll make it a little more dewy and radiant. But also, this can of course be worn on its own, and it just looks so beautiful and skin-like. I think a lot of times we hear foundations described as skin-like and they're not actually that skin-like. Like, they look kind of natural, but you would know that there's something on your face. You don't know. You don't know with this. But also, if you're pairing it with a little bit of concealer, some other products, you're still going to get some coverage. And I think it pairs well with other like lightweight, light coverage products. And I wore this the other day. Where was I going? I think we were going to pick up food or something. And I was like, you know what? I just want to do something light and easy. And I put this on my skin and I was so amazed at how beautiful it looks. Like, I feel like I'm falling back in love with it. I'm like looking in the car mirror and I'm like, my skin looks like my skin, but better. You can still see freckles through the skin, maybe some redness. I just feel like it's imperfectly perfect, and that's why I love it. Great for those no makeup makeup days or someone that likes a minimal look, which I feel like is super trendy right now. We're moving more towards light coverage foundations, and if you like super, super light slash sheer, try this one. This palette, I do not understand why it's not more popular. This is the Glitch palette from Ofra. And the reason I'm surprised that there's not more hype associated with this is because it's so on trend right now. These are the colors that are getting so much attention that we're seeing in so many looks. And I kind of thought that these pastel tones would really have their big moment in the springtime, and then we'd start to see them fade out, but we're still seeing such a push for pastel shadows. And I'm sitting here like, okay, well then why are we not talking about the Glitch? Because this is so beautiful. I do think there are two main reasons why this maybe isn't getting the hype that I feel it deserves. And the first one, I think we can all see it. I just think Ofra could have picked slightly more sleek of packaging to go with this. It did not need to be this big. But it is beautiful, we can't deny that. But also, it's a full shimmer palette. And I know for a lot of consumers, that's not a preference. For me, I like doing all shimmer looks, so I don't mind this, but I also recognize that it's not for everyone. But Ofra just created such a unique formula with this. They're really similar to their highlighters where they're baked and they're lightweight. These are different from any other shimmer eyeshadow that I've tried, and they're definitely more on the buildable side, but in the most beautiful way. Like, you can wear it really lightweight, blurred out, sheared out, or you can get more of an intense foiled look. I just feel like they're easy to work with. It's also a great pop of color palette. I've definitely used this on its own, but I also love wearing it when I want to pop a color. I'm actually wearing a little bit of it today. I just took this shade right here for the inner portion of the lid to lighten it up, and then this shade as my inner corner, but the main palette I'm wearing is the Mini Retro from Natasha Denona. But love this for a pop of color, for a fun inner corner highlight, for a beautiful halo eye. This is really good. Okay, Koki Cosmetics. You guys watched my drugstore tag video. That was supposed to be more of a question, not a statement. Like, you watched it, because I don't know if you did, but if you watched it, I mentioned Koki as the most underrated drugstore brand, and I really feel like they are, and I actually had to hold myself back from including so many Koki products in this video. I originally, on my little chair next to me where I keep my products, I had like their lip liners in there. I wanted to include the foundation. There were a lot of products that I wanted to feature in this video from certain brands, but I had to remind myself that I personally talk about those a lot. So even if they're maybe not hyped up by other YouTubers, like, I have probably talked them to death at this point. But this one, I don't talk about this enough. So I'm wearing the strobing palette today. I actually layered it. First, I put on Becca Opal, and then I took a little bit of this shade right here in the corner and layered it over top. This is also in my Shop My Stash rotation at the moment, and every time I wear this on camera, I really don't think I'm exaggerating here. Every time I wear this on camera, someone says, wait a minute, what is your highlighter? It looks amazing. And it's mostly been this palette. Today I had to force myself to reach for Opal because I was like, okay, Kelly, you've only been wearing the Koki palette. And then I still layered this on top. These three are powders. This one is definitely the best suited to my own skin tone. These two I like more as blush or bronze or toppers. But these two I do think would be really beautiful on a medium skin tone, and this one on like a deep skin tone. This one right here is a cream. Sometimes I wear it on its own. Sometimes I use it as a tacky base to put the other ones on top of. This impressed me so much, especially because this is the reformulated version. The first highlighter palette they came out with, I didn't like. They really changed it up with this one, and the formula is honestly like high-end. Do you know what these remind me of? I never made this connection until right now in this moment. They're very similar to the Anastasia highlighters that are in the Glow Kits. Like that really glowy texture, but almost kind of creamy to the touch. Yeah, they're very similar to that. Actually, I think a little creamier. All right, a liquid lipstick formula. I know liquid lipsticks are kind of like fading out. I know a lot of people are moving back to bullet lipsticks and formulas that are a little more comfortable, but this is a liquid lipstick formula that really is just as comfortable as a bullet lipstick. And this is the liquid lipstick formula from the Balm. I know you're like, why is it so small? I know, I have a mini, and it's actually what I'm wearing today. This shade, sadly, it was limited edition. It was in like a little set. The shade is called Humble. I really hope that they make this shade permanent though, because it's like my perfect nude. This formula is so comfortable. You know what it really reminds me of? The Persona Cosmetics liquid lip glosses, not liquid lip glosses, liquid lipsticks, because both formulas apply almost kind of like thin and runny, but they set down. Can you hear my dog snoring? They set down to like a really nice satin matte. And I just think they're so comfortable and easy to wear. So if you like the long lasting effect of a liquid lipstick, but you find that they can be kind of drying, try this formula from the Balm. And finally, this is a hair care product. This is the best dry shampoo to exist. It is, I was gonna say affordable. It's more on the affordable end than a lot of dry shampoos. It's cruelty-free, Leaping Bunny certified. This is the Eva NYC Freshen Up Dry Shampoo. You can pick this up at Ulta. I mentioned this in my most recent favorites video, and I had a few subscriber, not favorites, empties. And I had a few subscribers share that this is also your holy grail dry shampoo. This product will soak up every last bit of oil in your hair. I could even see some people finding it to be too intense, if that's possible. So if you don't like your dry shampoo to like really soak up everything and leave you really, really dried up, not dried up, that sounds bad, but it will take care of all the grease for you. If you like something a little more lightweight, maybe skip this one, but especially if you're out there trying to train your hair to go longer between washes, or you just need a very effective dry shampoo, this is the most effective powdery formula I have tried. Now, it does leave a slight white cast. Now that my hair is like a light brown, dark blonde, I don't notice it too much. Even back in the fall when I had more of a medium, like darkish brown hair color, I still found that if I sprayed it in, gave it a few minutes, and then like really brushed it in, it wasn't that noticeable. So I think you can kind of work around the white cast, but I would also love to see them come out with a brown hair version. I think that would, or like brown slash black, just like a darker hair color version. But truly, the most effective dry shampoo on the market that I have tried. So that's gonna go ahead, wrap up today's video. Those were some underrated products that I highly recommend checking out. A huge thank you to Skylar for working with me on today's video. It was so much fun to partner with them. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.